make one mistake and you're done. It's all about getting tough on a juvenile. And then you commit a crime like an adult, they gon' send you to the adult prison.
Yeah. Here we are, mere weeks away from the dawn of the new Judeo-Christian millennium. While factions from every corner of the fringe are running around espousing their prophecies of impending Armageddon, imminent rapture, or alien invasion, the institutional powers of the world are gearing up for the further consolidation of capital, wealth, and power. Meanwhile, the lower echelons of the global community are facing mounting financial insecurity, famine, and inevitable economic liquidation under the boot heels of neoliberalism. If contemporary patterns are allowed to progress, our generation will be fortunate enough to bear witness as the last of our forests are leveled, war, famine, and genocide encouraged on every continent, and the economic wealth of the world will continue its desiccating trickle upwards into the corporate reservoir. In a nutshell, we are standing before a massive precipice of destruction and getting a fat kick from behind. Whether or not this whole Y2K thing amounts to anything more than a few paranoid delusions, it has indeed provided us with a temporal impetus to step back and see where the world is headed. So this begs the question, where in the hell are the anarcho-punks during all this? What is perhaps the most ostensibly political subculture in northern society doing to either derail the evil plans of global power, or even to save our own asses? Unfortunately, as I look at the scenes around me, the only answer I see is not a hell of a lot. It seems that our self-labeled, aware, and educated subculture finds record collecting, trivial scene politics, and watching The Simpsons to be of greater efficacy than it actualizing the slogans on our patches. While Rome is engulfed in flames around us, we exercise the freedom given to us by economic privilege to ignore the screams of our neighbors and sit quietly, dare I say meekly, content in our marginal little subculture. And damn it, this isn't good enough. There can be no justification for a subculture that at once pats itself on the well-spiked back for how great it is to be DIY and a political anti-authoritarian anarchist, while at the same time doing all too little to effect real change in our own lives or our own communities, much less in places like Mexico, Rwanda, Colombia, or Kosovo. There is no excuse for the piddly feel-good bullshit we call activism in a subculture that has all the resources of the first world behind it. And let's face it, the stakes are high and only getting higher. And if we expect, or even would like, to help end this planetary downward spiral, we need to elevate our sights and shoot to kill. We need to jump off the treadmill of the "it's better than nothing" school of activism, allowing our noble yet ineffective tactics of watered-down protest, transparent political rhetoric, to go the way of flat planets and grunge. We need to lay a new foundation for our politics based not on 19th century Marxist slogans or half-assed ideological assumptions, but on the demands and conditions of the real world as it is happening in the here and now. It is no longer relevant or valid just to say, fuck capitalism or fuck money. We must necessarily bring our politics into the new millennium. We must necessarily say, fuck the neoliberal model, fuck the IMF, fuck structural adjustment programs, fuck the multilateral agreement on investment, and have 6 pages of footnoted facts to back us up. If we do not at once update and substantiate our convictions, we will never progress out of the well-greased rut of half-assed, fact-free demos and political impotence where we remain stuck today. Lastly, and perhaps most importantly, let's talk about wrecking shit. If we are really serious about dismantling the corporate yoke, conserving what little is left of our wildlands, and spawning a new age of respect for all life, we need to get up off of our knees, stop spare changing the institutional powers that be, and start taking what we want, what we demand, and what we need. It is high time that we as a subculture, we as a community, and we as a people cease the pathetic trend of begging, complaining, and excuse-mongering against what is wrong and start taking control ourselves. You ever wonder what happened to anarchism over the past 60 or 70 years? Ever wonder how a once powerful and threatening political force could be reduced to its current status as a laughable, insignificant ideology for a couple subcultures of the first world fringe? Well, once upon a time, anarchists stood for something, anarchists had something, and anarchists did something. And somewhere along the way, we dropped the ball and became an ideology defined not by what we believe or what we do, by what we don't do. We hate government and pigs. We are anti-racist, anti-sexist, anti-homophobic. We hate inequality and oppression. But rarely, if ever, in today's debate, do we ever have anything to offer but these oppositions. And let's face it, being an anti-racist doesn't feed a hungry baby. Being anti-homophobic doesn't put that Iraqi child's legs back on, and being anti-authoritarian doesn't save that last ecosystem from being turned into toilet paper. Unless we take our antipathy and use it not as a tool to complain, but as a tool to create. Malcolm X once wrote that the most effective way to bring down states and effect change was to create a better alternative that could make its oppressive predecessor obsolete. And damn it, if we want to have any hope of bringing down the United States and all of its nasty isms, we need to get to work making better structures, better institutions, and better communities. It is time to stop being perpetually reactive to the world around us, and time to start changing the world through our own action. Yeah, I know this sounds ridiculous, but think about it. We live in one of the richest nation states on the planet. We have all the same resources as notoriously powerful groups like the Christian Coalition, the Nation of Islam, or the Republicrats. We just choose to ignore them, where they choose to use them to their own benefit. Or perhaps worse, we even pretend to abdicate them in some delusionary attempt at removing ourselves from privilege and the guilt it entails. Ask yourself this: what is better for the earth? What is better for the poor? And what is better for the future victims of genocide? Us pretending to be poor and remaining powerless, vicarious victims? Or standing up with your friends, your families, and your communities, pulling your ample resources and getting to work changing this fucked up world? Now is the time for us to make cops obsolete by securing our own homes and our own neighborhoods. Now is the time to make suicidal industrial agriculture and its ensuing cycle of dependency obsolete by growing our own food and setting up our own systems of distribution and storage. Now is the time for us to revolt against exploitative medicine by enhancing our abilities to heal ourselves. Now is the time to make the military obsolete by forming our own community militias. And lastly, it is time we destroy the government by creating sustainable institutions based on liberty, justice, and respect. For if we do not create before we destroy, we are left with nothing. People, the time is now. History has amply illustrated what must be done, and indeed has provided us with the means to enact serious change. Now, we must take in the slack and get to work toppling the power structures in this fucked up world. No more slogans, no more excuses, no more blinding our eyes and baring our asses to the world. We have the power, we have the resources, we have the energy. Let's get together and wreck shit.
Jesus.